Yesterday, one of you asked me in the comments, the quality of your videos is always amazing, could we get a video export settings video? Now, look, I don't know if it looks amazing. I think it looks pretty good, but amazing is like, that's a whole other level, right? And it also took me a while to get where I am now, because if you compare my old videos to my most recent videos, wow, what a difference. But anyway, doesn't matter, you want to know my export settings in DaVinci Resolve 17? No problem, and I'll also give you some extra tips and tricks that I use to get the best quality video. Okay, now, before I reveal my export settings in DaVinci Resolve 17, there's something you need to understand, and I always compare it to poop. Yeah, you heard it right, poop. Because if you look down the toilet after you took a dump and what you see worries you, well, then you've probably been eating crap the whole week. Frozen pizza, donuts, you know, stuff that looks good, but stuff that affects the output. And it's the same for video. If you want the highest quality video here on YouTube after uploading, then you need to start editing with high quality footage, because maybe your shots look awesome and dynamic, but if the image quality is poor to begin with, then, well, YouTube compression is like your digestive system. It needs high quality input if you want high quality output. You know, a big, nice, consistent, firm. And it's not just the camera settings. Because sometimes I read in the comments something like, yeah, I have the same camera as you and I use the same camera settings, but still my footage, my videos don't look the same, or it doesn't look like it's the same quality. And yeah, I know, it's tricky. Now, camera settings are important, but I almost never use crazy advanced settings for my videos here on YouTube. I think the most important settings are, well, first of all, I shoot in 4K. 1080 also looks really good, even if I blow it up to 4K, but I think if you really want the highest quality after uploading, shooting in 4K will make a big difference, even though most people watch YouTube videos on their phone. But it still makes a difference, I think. Now, the thing is, most of you probably won't notice any difference if I all of a sudden start shooting in 1080, but yeah, you know, I always recommend if you can shoot in 4K and you can edit it smoothly and you don't have any problems with storing your bigger files, then why not? Just shoot in 4K. But I'm gonna say it again, don't worry if you can't shoot in 1080, especially here on YouTube, 1080 looks great. And then there's also sharpening. Now, usually for important projects, I prefer to turn off sharpening in camera and add it in post. But most of these videos, you know, talking head videos, vlogs, reviews, things like that, I shoot in S-Log 2 or 3, I set the sharpening detail to -4, and I don't add any sharpening in post. 4K, S-Log, sharpening detail to -4. That's it. That's what you see pretty much every video in the last couple of months. Oh, and it's 24 frames per second and a shutter of 1/50th, most of the time. Sometimes 30 frames per second, 1/60th, but most of the time 24 frames per second. And of course, I'm usually shooting with my Sony a7S III, which also makes a big difference, because if I shoot with my Canon M50, well, it won't look the same. It will look good, definitely, but it won't look the same and it won't have the same image quality. That's just how it is. But anyway, so yeah, camera settings are all pretty basic. Just follow the general guidelines to get good footage, I guess. Now, what's also important? Color grading, lighting, exposure. Because if your lighting is off or if your color grading is too bland, then that will also affect how your audience experiences your footage. They might feel like it doesn't look as good. If you want to make your footage look the same as what you see here in my video, then I can give you my exact camera settings. But if you don't have the same lighting, the same color grading, then it will never look exactly the same. Even though the image quality, objectively, is exactly the same. You know what I mean? So what I'm trying to say is that it's very difficult to try and make your footage look exactly like the footage of another YouTuber. It's almost impossible because there are way too many variables. Now, one thing I do sometimes, and this is important, especially here on YouTube, sometimes I add grain to my footage. Because YouTube's compression sometimes causes banding. You know, those ugly blocks of color where the color should gradually change? Especially when your image has large blue areas, but also black or any large uniform colored areas. Adding grain helps to avoid that ugly banding effect that's caused by YouTube's compression. Okay, and now my export settings in DaVinci Resolve 17. And honestly guys, it's all super, super basic. I use a custom profile here in the export tab. I use .mov. I've also used MP4 before, which supposedly is more compressed, but I didn't see that much of a difference. I also set it to H.264 here, 4K of course, and the frame rate, always the frame rate of my timeline, 24 or 23.976, which is what my Sony shoots. And this is really important, bitrate. I don't leave it on automatic. For a 4K video, I usually set it to 50,000 as a minimum. If it's a color heavy video, like maybe with a lot of sunsets, dramatic sunsets, then I bump it up to 60 or 70,000. It does affect the file size, but it also affects image quality because YouTube's compression is unforgiving and the more bitrate you have, the better it is to keep the quality after the upload. But that's pretty much it. All the rest is just default settings. And a 10-minute video is usually something around 3-4 gigabytes. Oh, and another maybe important thing, for these talking head videos, I always shoot in 8-bit. And when you're shooting an S-log, they say it's better to shoot in 10-bit, but for these kind of videos, I don't see a significant difference, so there's really no reason to like bump it up to 10-bit with bigger file sizes. I just shoot in 8-bit, it's fine. Now, if I want to do some heavy color grading or if it's a more important project, then I switch to 10-bit, of course. And yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching, guys. And remember, if you look down the toilet and what you see worries you, start eating healthier, yeah? Okay, see you in the next one.